Welcome back to my channel, guys. It's your girl, Coco Styles. And on this channel, we talk about beauty, fashion, and lifestyle. I also run a blog called Coco Styles NYC, where I talk about fashion and give you guys style advice on how to style certain things like jeans and t-shirts and dresses and shoes for tall women and all that good stuff. So in today's video, I wanted to give you guys some key essentials that you need in your closet. Now, a lot of us do have the typical standard closet, which is the small closet, but a lot of us also have rooms that we have now merged into a full closet, or we just have a typical walk-in closet. So I'm just gonna jump right into it. And I would say the number one thing you should have in your closet, a part of your closet, is a steamer. Steamer or an iron. I'm not really big on ironing because I feel like there's always something wrong with it. So I would prefer a steamer. A steamer is awesome. I will link some below. There are very, very good ones out there for a very good price. The best one I would say would be the standing steamer, which is a little bit more pricey, but you do have brands that have really good ones for about 50 bucks. So that is number one, a steamer. Number two, I would say would be lint brushes. Have a whole bunch of them, okay? Because there's times where you may have something that has a little bit of fur on it, some sort of hair may end up on an item that you put next to by accident. So having a lint brush is essential, and I also think it's essential to have a small one in your purse or something, because you never know, if you're out, something may get a little linty, or someone's jacket, fur from their jacket may get on your clothes. So you don't wanna walk around looking like a cat sat on you. So having a lint brush, a personal one in one of your closet, is another essential. Number two, I would say, would be cedar balls. Cedar balls are good for like moths and stuff like that. No one wants to use mothballs in their closet. So cedar balls are a good thing to use. I think Target has them. They're not expensive, or just try good old Amazon. So number three would be cedar balls. Number four would be a sweater brush, not a brush, a sweater comb. So a sweater comb is kind of like, hey, I know someone who actually used the eyebrow thing to get like lint balls off of their sweater. But you could buy the actual sweater comb and it'll get like the little balls off of your sweater. Or even like sometimes some your pants may have it, some sweatpants may have it, to get the little balls off of it. That's another essential you should have in your closet, and probably carry that around with you sometimes. So that's number four, a sweater brush. Number five would be a sewing kit. Every woman needs a small sewing kit in their closet. Even if you do not have, don't know, if you, even if you don't know how to put the dag on thread through the needle, it's something that is needed. Things happen when we're getting dressed, something tears really quick, but enough to where you could actually do a quick fix. So I definitely think it's essential to have those, along with, of course, everything that comes inside of it, thread, needles, pins, safety pins, anything. So a sewing kit is also essential. Number six would be huggable hangers. A, we like hangers, we like sturdy hangers. So I would recommend you guys always having wood hangers for your heavier things and keep those together. And then keep the huggable hangers for your other stuff. And the reason why I say huggable hangers is because they're thin and it allows you to have more stuff on your closet or your rack. So right now, it's not a lot of stuff on here, but I have the wood hangers. And these are actually from Target. And I think they're pretty, not Target, IKEA. I think they're pretty good. But if I would have had the huggable ones on here, I would definitely be able to fit a lot more stuff in here. So that is number five, huggable hangers. Number six, I would say, is storage bins. Storage bins are for when you are doing your seasonal closet edits. I would say storage bins because you do not always want to put everything inside of garment bags. And you also can just store a bunch of stuff in there that's just miscellaneous things. So number six, I would say, is storage bins, and invest in some good ones that are able to be stacked on top of each other. What you don't want to do is have a whole bunch of bins straight across in your closet and not utilizing the layer on top of it. So that is number six, storage bins. Number seven, I would say, would be a full length mirror. You need it, guys. For many, many years, I just was like, I don't need a mirror. I would look at the mirror before I left home or the mirror at work. I felt like I looked fine, or when I got on the subway, I would see a reflection. But it's important to look in the mirror, and actually I would say have more than one, because sometimes these mirrors are made not the best way with not the best glass, and sometimes it can give you like a funny image, or you can just have two and you're good to go. One doesn't look good, look at the other one. So that's number seven, I would say mirrors. Number eight would be a stool. Having a stool in your closet, perfect. Because guess what? You just now stored all of your stuff away in your closet, on the top of your closet, and now you need to get to it. And you're short, or you're just not tall enough for it. So having a good stool in there, and make sure that it's multi-useful. Something that you could actually sit on later on and actually step on it. So sometimes they have stools that have benches that have stools under them that you can pull out and step on. So try to get one that's used for multiple purposes, so you're not really clouding up your closet with a bunch of junk on the floor. So that is number eight, a stool. Number nine would be drawer organizers. So if you are a person who have now created a walk-in closet from a bedroom, or if your walk-in closet is large enough to have a dresser in there, you are going to need drawer dividers. That way your stuff is not spilling over to the other side. And the reason why I say that is because women wear bras and panties. Some have big ones, some have small ones. And it's a little bit easier if you have the divider in the middle, so your thongs are not really mixing in with the other ones, because it can get a little messy. So that is number nine, drawer divider. Number 10 would be jewelry organizers. So having a jewelry organizer is the best thing. I wish I had it in here, but I don't. You can display the stuff that you actually really like on display that you wear kind of every day, your everyday jewelry. And maybe your rings, and I'm sure they have things where you can put rings on it, but display your jewelry is another good way to have your closet look like a boutique, but it's also a good essential to have, so your necklaces are not being tangled up with each other and you're able to hang them on this jewelry organizer. So those are my 10 essentials that every closet needs. It's not that it makes it functioning or anything like that, but I think it's something that we need. Like example, a sewing kit. It's something that we probably don't think we're gonna need often, but hey, you may be getting dressed one day and tear something, or a button pops up and you have a sewing kit. So you don't have to literally take your outfit and just say, forget it. So those are just a few essentials that I think every closet should have just to be functioning on that side, on the things that we actually need. So if you like videos like this, please comment below. And if you stay to the end of this video, please comment Coco, we see you. And guys, don't forget to follow me on Instagram at CocoStylesNY. And again, guys, my blog also is CocoStylesNYC. And I will catch you guys in the next one. Bye.